Have you ever needed to abbreviate a very large number? What about format currencies depending on the different locale? Or have you ever needed a very specific date format or needed to know how long ago a previous date was? Formatting a timestamp with hours, minutes, seconds. What about measurements that adapt to the device's locale, like going from feet to meters? I'm going to show you an API and a resource that will help you format all kinds of things in Swift. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. All right, here I am in Xcode with a very basic starter project. I just have a VStack with a text that has my view count in here, which is 21,500,000 something, and a spacer to push it up to the top and some extra padding. But what I'm going to show you right now is how to format this 21,523,821 very large number that you see over in the preview into something nice and neat like this 21.5 million. That's the first example we're going to do. So before I show you the resource, I'm going to type this out. Because when you see me type this, you're gonna be like, how the hell did you know all that? And that's where the resource comes in. So down here in my text, we're gonna get rid of that view count, get the text autocomplete. You'll see source and format. So you can pass in a date. We're gonna pass in the equitable one. And the input is going to be view count. That's this big number here. Now, this format is where, like I said, you can format all kinds of options. So I'm gonna show you one that's pretty long. And like I said, you're gonna be like, how did you know that? And we'll get to that. So we'll say dot number dot notation dot compact name. There you go, that's 22 million. But you might also be saying, well, that's not granular enough. I want the 21.5 million or 21.52 million. How granular do you wanna be in this abbreviation? So if you're okay with it rounding to the nearest million, yeah, you just do compact name. But now you can also control the precision and fraction length. And you can do zero dot 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 two. That will give me two decimal places. What if I only want one decimal place? Go ahead and change that to a one. There you go. What if I want three? There you go. There's three decimal places. What about four? I don't know why you'd want four, but there's four. Okay, that's a bad abbreviation. You probably don't want that. Most likely, you want one or two. But look how easily, right? It was one line of code already built into the Swift UI text view to give me that nice abbreviation. Now, where did I know to do number, dot notation, dot precision, dot fraction length? Like, how do you know all that stuff? Well, this is the relatively new formatter API that was introduced, I believe, in iOS 15. So by now it's a couple years old, but this was a huge game changer because before iOS 15, you had to format all this stuff yourself. It was a nightmare. And as you can imagine, there's like endless permutations of how you can format things. So that's where our resource comes in. It's a beautiful website called Gosh Darn Format Style, or if you like to be vulgar, there's another version. I won't say it, but you can read it right up there. But let's go back to the PG version. So as you can see on the left here, we have all different styles: number style, percent style, currency style, all different things. And if you go through, it breaks down basically the entire formatter API with all these examples. So you can see we have dot number, dot rounded. This is rounding to different decimals. And then you see over on the right, all the comments show you the output of all these variations. And again, this is a huge, long website. Luckily, it's broken down into sections. So for example, I scroll down, I was looking for precision. Okay, cool. This is where I can do, you know, significant digits or a fraction length. That's where I learned how to control how many decimals I wanted to show. Ah, here's that notation section, right? I knew I wanted the compact name, that 1K, 21 million, whatever it is. And just to show you how like flexible that is, back to Xcode, let's say I deleted the last three digits. Now it's just 21,523. There you go. You get 21.52K. Do Command Z to go back and then back to the resource. So yeah, it's dates, percentage, currencies. Let's actually go back to Xcode to show you this. Instead of number notation, I can do currency and then the code. Now this is the country code. So we'll do GPB for pounds. There you go. There's pounds. Let's do JPY for yen. Let's do USD for dollar. Now I'm hard coding that string, but you can pull this code from the device locale. So the proper currency symbol will show up for whatever locale the device is in. But look how easily I got 21.52 million, nicely abbreviated, formatted with the proper currency signal in just like one line of code. So this formatter API is amazing. Like I said, the tricky thing is that there's just so much. I'm just scroll down so far, you know, percent styles. There's just, again, a lot of permutations, way to do this, percent, rounding, towards zero, down, up, away from zero. And you can basically format like anything you want. And this site, Gosh Darn Format Style, is my go-to. It essentially breaks down every possible permutation for numbers, percentage, currencies, dates. Let's talk about dates. This is the last example I'll do because obviously I can't run through all of these. But let's talk about dates. Let's say you needed a very specific date format. Actually, before I do that, I do want to showcase how I use this because as you can imagine, you have all these super long formats in your text in SwiftUI. Your UI code will get a little out of control. So what I like to do is create something like view string, can name it better if you like, that is a string. And that will return viewCount.formatted. And then this is where we can pull in .number, .notation, .compactName, .precision, .fractionLength, 0, dot, 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 2. And then instead of having all this in my view code, I can just do text, view string, and there you go, the view code is nice and neat. I'm gonna actually get rid of my navigator over here to make that on one line. And you can create a custom formatter so you don't have this really long thing, or there's many other ways you can like refactor it to get this kind of out of your code. But for one more example, let's talk about a very specific date format and then also a relative date format to get this, you know, time ago text. All right, so below our view string, let's do another text. Again, it's source and format, and then we want a time data source because we're working with dates, so we can do dot now, and then the format is gonna be dot date time dot month. And here's where, again, back to gosh darn format style. If we go to date and time style, actually, I want to go to the composition part of it, right? You can see all the puzzle pieces: day, day of the year, era, hour, month, minute, quarter, second, time zone, weekday, right? You basically have all these date puzzle pieces that you can put together to format the date however you like. So back to Xcode, I'll show you that. Then we're going to do dot month. And then each of these puzzle pieces also has a format. So I can do dot month, abbreviated, narrow. So if I do narrow, that's just going to be M for May. Abbreviated, well, May abbreviated is M-A-Y, but November would be N-O-V. And then we'll do day. Day also has formats as well. We'll just do default digits. I can do time, and I can do dot hour. And again, the format, we'll do conversational default digits, and the PM can be abbreviated, narrow, omitted, wide, let's do wide. So May 30th at 5 a.m. That is a pretty unique date format. Right, it's not the typical month, day, year, but you see how I can put these puzzle pieces together with the different formats of the puzzle pieces to basically format anything I want. And again, that's why this site is all so valuable, is because all these puzzle pieces are broken down so you know what's possible, and it's just it's a great resource, again, to format anything. All right, let's get to this relative date style. So you can see this like 2 weeks ago, 3 months ago, whatever that is. So we'll go back to our Xcode here. Let's create a property real quick, like view count, we'll say a while ago, and that equals date, time interval since now, say minus one, I don't know, I just put a whole bunch of zeros down there, a long, long time ago. So now in our text, we can be like, well, how long ago was that? And this is what you'll see in like social media posts, like this was posted 1 hour ago, this was posted 2 weeks ago, this was posted 1 year ago. That's a very common use case for this. So I'll scroll up a bit, and text, we want the source and format, so we'll say a while ago, format will be dot relative, and the presentation and unit style. So the presentation will be named, and then now the unit style is where things get different. So you can say abbreviated, 32 years ago. That's how long ago that was. Okay, let's make this shorter here. How long ago was that? What is that, 10,000 seconds? Okay, that was 3 hours ago, but that's what abbreviated looks like. What does narrow look like? 3 hours ago. That's kind of what you see in the social media apps. All right, now what about spell out? All right, I've never really seen that before, but maybe you do. Maybe you have a unique style that you wanted to say 3 hours ago. What's the other one? Wide, 3 hours ago, fully spelled out. And again, I'm gonna change the time here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, whatever. Just put a bunch of seconds in there. That was 39 years ago. So again, the Formatter API came out in iOS 15. It is amazing. However, there's an endless amount of permutations you can do. So how do you even know what's possible? Well, that is where this amazing site, gosh darn format style, comes in. Again, you have number styles, percent styles, currency, dates, times, measurements, units. It's just an amazing resource. This saved me so much time when I was building my app. And if you're here learning how to format text so it looks amazing in your project, I know you're building awesome apps. And you're gonna need a website for that app. And I also recommend having a developer portfolio to showcase all your awesome work. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're developers, we can build a website ourselves, but we're also iOS developers, and I would argue there's an opportunity cost of your time. Now, do you want to spend your time learning about web development, responsive design, all the different browsers, or do you want to spend your time building apps? So that's why I always recommend letting Squarespace take that off your plate to build your iOS developer portfolio. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started, and you can use their next generation website editor with the Fluid Engine to just really unlock all the creativity in the world. You can even use Squarespace Blueprint and Squarespace AI to help you figure out what to write on your website, because that's always the hardest part. Like, I don't even know what to say here. Throw it into Squarespace's AI and they'll help you out. They handle all the SEO and analytics for you. Again, Squarespace handling your website just takes so much off your plate. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.